See, one thing I want to also tell you is that it's not only about the location also. We must that person must see, or that group of people who are doing that industry must see what is the cost in the market. Suppose I'm making a cricket ball. Suppose I'm making a TMT bar only. I'm talking about iron because I know about that. There's a market rate of iron. Or steel. So that's a place where a bidding goes on, a rate is fixed, the price of Coal India. Go to the Coal India website, there are biddings going on, you can bid, you can see even what is the coal rates all over India today. Iron rates come from Punjab. It's called some mandis there. It's called forgetting the name again. I'm bad at names. I'll remember it. So that's a place where it decides what is the rate of iron. All over India, the iron rates go. So I just cannot make a rod and sell it in the market. I have to go with the market rate, right? I can increase my price by saying that these are my qualities, but I cannot go sky high. People won't buy it. I cannot make one rod and keep it for 6 months in my factory and claim that okay, my rod is good, and after 6 months I sell them, but by 6 months my expenditure in my factory has gone up. Do I get back that money after selling it? That also depends. So everything depends upon, you know what, like the cost of obtaining at the what cost I'm obtaining the this thing, cost of my distribution and production, cost of the production site where my finishing thing is coming out. If I ever get a chance, I'll show you guys a video how the steel is made, how a rod is made, how sheets are made, how iron angles are made. You know, in our school we have the adjuster seat and we have those angles with hooks. So how those angles are made, I have videos with me, but if I ever get a chance, I'm sure to you. So if the finishing point matters, how much we are expending, how much are we spending on that production site? One is the factory site, one is the production site. We have to know. And then there is transportation site. So in the factory, the most important part is the weigh bridge. What weight is coming on and what weight is going out. Then only we can classify or we can decide what factory I want to make. That depends upon the site. Okay, that matters a lot. So now, classification of industries. How do we classify? On the basis of raw materials. Today I'll just give you a brief explanation, like what is it all about, and we'll go ahead with it. Okay. What raw material I'm getting close by so that I can compete in the market with the better product. It's a competition thing, you know. That doesn't mean you get bad burgers in your area in Kamtol and you'll get good burgers in Muzaffarpur. But if you want to eat a Muzaffarpur made burger, you have to travel that distance. You know, that petrol, or you're coming by auto, or you're giving so much of time to it. You're telling your father has to leave some important work, which is going to, he's going to lose money. So that cost depends. To eat that 30 rupees burger, or 25, or 50, or 100, whatever, you are spending another extra on it. Availability. But if you have it in Muzaffarpur, if you tell that guy, you see, this is how it is made in Muzaffarpur, and if that guy has got better thing, to make and you love that taste. People of Madhapurpur don't know that he is here. But if he extends his business, if he knows that, okay, this is my customer happening to me. Today I have got 100 customers. In 3 months' time, I got 100 customers. I should expand my business. He makes another cart. In your area only, he starts selling it with another guy with the same quality. He gets those extra 10 more customers. But he has to see that with those 10 extra customers, am I being able to pay up this guy who I've recruited? Labor. Production. How much production is it giving? Quality has to be maintained. There are a lot of things, you know, it's not so easy. We think, oh, industrialist, oh, this is happening, that is happening. You know, Reliance must be, he must be banging his head every day on the desk. He may be one of the rich people, but he's got more tension. Two people have got problem, the rich people and the people who want to become rich. Two type of people have got problem in the society. The one who are millionaires, and the ones who want to become millionaires. Rest, no one has got problem. They are all happy. The day you want to become something, or you want to copy something, that day your problem starts. But if you follow your own instincts, there will be no problems at all. I am challenging you. There will be no problems at all. Okay. So, classification of industries on the base of raw materials, agro-based industries, cotton, woolen, jute, silk, textile, rubber, sugar, tea, coffee, etc., etc., etc. Mineral-based industries, iron, steel, cement, aluminium, petrochemicals, etc., etc., etc. Now, they need the raw materials. Right? Agro-based industries you can make next to the village areas or the in the farming areas, agriculture areas. But again, the government has to support and see that if that industry is allowed to be made, that land is they are acquiring, is it for industrial land or not? Again, also that depends. You know, there is farming land, there is waste land. You have read it before also. Pollution also matters. Mineral-based industries, iron, steel, what are the things they need? Iron and steel, I know we need iron ore. According to their main role, basic or key industries, you know, these industries supply their products or raw materials to manufacture other goods. Example, iron and steel, copper smelting, aluminium smelting. Smelting is not melting. Making something out is called smelters. These industries supply their products of raw material to manufacture other goods. There are industries, small industries, who bring in the raw material and they send it to them. Consumer industries, these industries produce goods which are directly used by consumers. Example, sugar, paper, electronics, soap, etc., etc., etc. Now, on the basis of capital investment of the money, small-scale industries and a large-scale industry. A small-scale industry for capital is up to 1 crore investment. Then the industry is called a small-scale industry. And if the invested capital is more than 1 crore, the industry is called a large-scale industry. Okay. These are the basic things I'm telling you. Then it's on the basis of ownership, public sector, private sector, joint sector, cooperative sector. These industries are owned and operated by the government agencies, SAIL, BHEL, ONGC. Private sector, you know, the only king, Reliance, TISCO, Mahindra, okay. Then we have Aditya Birla Groups, Tata's, Birla's. Joint sector, these industries are jointly owned by the government and individuals or a group of individuals, Oil India Limited, Bharat Petroleum, Indian Oil. What is a cooperative sector? These industries are owned and operated by the producers or suppliers of raw materials, workers or both. The resources are pooled by each stakeholder. Pooled means everyone puts in, and profits or losses are shared proportionately. Amul, which is milk cooperative, is a good example. Sugar industry in Maharashtra is another example. The women in Gujarat, Rajasthan, they know the cooperative, the milk cooperative, they are also earning. But again, one thing, you have to make sure you take care of the losses also. If there is a loss, you have also have to face that. That doesn't mean I'm pulling in money, that there's going to be a loss, I'll say give back my money. No, we have to face the loss also. Then there is a based on the weightage of the raw materials. There is heavy industry and light industry. Heavy industry is iron and steel, light industry is electronics. That is based on the bulk and weight of raw materials and finished goods. I can give you information about aluminium smelting, textile industry, industry. Okay. So we'll keep it till here. And the next class I'll come and read. And that is going to be the classification industries. I did not read it out to you. But I will tell you all about it once we read, and then we'll come to, I have to explain the textile industry, cotton textiles, and then we have why did Mahatma Gandhi lay emphasis on spinning yarn and weaving khadi, that was only for made in India. And then we have the jute textile, sugar industry. I'll explain everything one after another. The mineral based, my best one will be the mineral based, and the iron and steel industry. So we'll keep it till here. You guys take care and read and try to understand actually what is happening here in the classification. See, industry, what is it giving to the country? You know, you cannot do anything. You can come to know why is it giving this much, why is it helping the GDP, it's only upon their location and classification. Everything depends upon that location. Each price, even of a needle, depends upon the location of that place. Okay, so see you in the next class. Till then, you take care and bye bye. God bless all of you. Respect your parents. Teacher's Day is coming. Instead of wishing your school teachers, you will wish if you get a chance on the group. But you must wish the unacademic teachers also as well. So the world's best teachers are your parents. Wish them first and then you wish your teachers, or put a message. Even if you learned something from anybody else, unacademic means not from the school. Something else from anybody you have learned, even you have learned to sing, or you have learned to say a new word, that is also you have learned from someone. Give them thanks and wish them happy Teachers Day. Yeah, someone is teaching you something. I am a sharer, so my sharing day does not come. I have to check on Mother Google to see what is the sharing day, which day it comes. I'll let you know. So till then, take care, God bless, and keep rocking, and stay home, stay safe. Bye bye.